He was one of daytime's rising stars on The Young and the Restless. Then Tom Beard suddenly walked away.
He was one of soap opera's biggest stars.
He was on top of the soap opera world.
I don't understand.
Every major soap magazine and thousands of fans wanted a piece of him. But after 3 years, at the peak of his career as Philip Chancellor on The Young and the Restless, a murder in his hometown of Kenosha, Wisconsin, shatters his world.
Beard's turned to the canvas after a tragedy of his own, a schizophrenic brother who murdered their mom.
She had a problem with me, and she'd say, at first she said, you got a problem with school, you got school for, but she'd tell me what I had a problem with, and I okay, you know, you're my mom, I believe you, and, we went for treatment for school phobia, and we were just talking, and he's telling me to feel hot or paranoid or this and that. And I was in jail at the time. I might have thought of Charlie Manson in the eyes, and went from there. Like, I could have went into, you know, you sometimes think that prisoners are cool to each other and everything, and, you know, they'll fight for you or whatever, protect you, maybe like a big guy, a little guy, or just rape or whatever. I used him, and he showed me what to do with this power.
I know that this is my little brother, and there was a while when I forgot that, and I'm very glad that we have this relationship again. And he knows how important he is to me.
Yeah. We'll meet you waiting time that leads us to the person that forgives is the one that gets the gift, because I thought I was doing her a favor and him a favor, and I was the one that got everything. So, you know, that's what forgiving, you know, is, and I know that.
The paintbrush became Beard's therapy.
Because it keeps me right in the moment there.
These days, I live full-time in Lake Arrowhead, California, such a beautiful place. As a full-time artist, painting is my passion.
Here with Tom Beards. Tom, thank you so much for coming in.
Sure, my pleasure to be here.
You are just amazing. Your artwork is phenomenal. It has that impressionist quality to it. Just so wonderful. I know that there are a lot of also, you know, celebrities who are collecting your art.
Mm-hmm. It's true. Many celebrities own Beards's.
My latest mission takes place in a world in which millions of dollars change hands every year. The LA art scene. Juan's challenged me to test his security by trying to steal a painting from his gallery. I reveal our target for this job. The House of Doria. A painting by Tom Beards, one of LA's hottest young artists.
I don't love acting like I love painting, but every once in a while I'm on the set.
On The Young and the Restless, our Entertainment Tonight cover story.
And you felt trapped.
In my own skin. That's what I'm talking about. Who am I? You guys don't know who I am.
You don't know who I am.
Put on some clothes, all right? I want to get something to eat before we go to that gallery opening.
Oh. Hey, baby.
Hey.
Hey, Nathan, how you doing?
Hey, Bobby. Good.
Would you join us for lunch?
No, you know, I've got a lot of...
Looks good.
Oh, but...
My brother killed our mom in the kitchen with a baseball bat. So I'm sure this indicates that. He said she was a nag. But I intentionally tried to hide the gravity in this piece. The numbing by overstimulus. That's pretty much why I left Hollywood after 29 years. And now I live in an isolated cabin in the woods painting pictures.
Hollywood lights replaced with Lake Arrowhead trees. Beards retreats to what he calls his treehouse and invites me into his home and into his conscience.
I've had the honor of working with Jeannie Cooper, one of the soap opera greats.
From The Young and the Restless.
This lady helped me so much. Didn't want to make this just a pretty picture because she was a lot more than just a pretty picture.
Every weekend, 20 years ago, I would fly to different malls in the country and I would sign autographs. One time in Toronto, 7,000 people showed up and a girl asked a question. She said, do you have a girlfriend? And I said, no. And they screamed excitedly, you know, because they thought I was straight and I wanted them to believe I was straight. I could not tell them that my boyfriend was right there in the audience supporting me.
My brother, who eventually killed himself, was sucked into a very unhealthy relationship.
When Tom's other brother, Craig, committed suicide.
He was sitting on the closet floor. He had shot himself through his mouth in a depression.
He transformed into kind of a rabbit, a scared rabbit. And the gold ropes confining him became this clown mouth, and I added clown eyes and a clown nose, because forcing anybody to love you is such a ridiculous thing.
What gave you the strength to be sitting here today?
You know, I'm not sure of that. I'm gay, and as a young child, sometimes if you're gay, you separate, because...
Sure.
Being raised Catholic, I was told I was going to hell.
Of course.
So you kind of put a distance between you, and you learn to be more of a survivor.
Interesting.
That may be the reason.
Did many paintings trying to capture the peaceful solitude of nature.
Tonight, in this historic event, everybody, Tom Beers did this.
Back here live, you can see Tom's work through this weekend. His paintings and the variety of styles may catch you off guard.
Hi there, my name is Tom Beards. I'm an artist, president of the American Art Awards.
And I truly believe I am the happiest man on earth. My life is fantastic. Yes, I certainly triumphed over tragedy.